Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question here about career and studying. This question comes from Gabriel, and he says, "Hi, John, I have a question for you, which I'm hoping you might be able to help me with. I'm currently working full-time as a system admin and studying a Bachelor of Computer Science part-time with the goal of moving my career from system admin into software development. I've been offered a position with significantly higher pay still working as a system administrator. If I were to accept this position, I would have to change my university studies as the job is in a different area. I have found out I can either continue my bachelor studies via correspondence or I could step straight into a master's of mobile application development. The graduation date would be the same, but the cost is significantly more for the master's, approximately 20K more. What are your thoughts on the value of postgraduate qualifications? Or in a similar vein to one of your recent videos on boot camps, would I be better off finishing my bachelor and pursuing online courses to teach myself mobile application development? The bachelor teaches the fundamentals and theory, but not so much how to practically write an application, whereas the master's, oddly enough, is more practical and even taught by professionals in the industry. I'd really appreciate your insights. Cheers, Gabriel." So there's a couple of things, Gabriel. You didn't even really ask this question, but I'm gonna start with this, which is, I'd say to start off by taking the higher paid system admin job while you learn software development. And the reason why I say that is because if you got an opportunity to make significantly more money, it would be better to take that opportunity and to utilize that money to invest or to further your career and your learning in software development. More experience in a higher position is always good, and may lend its opportunity to a software development job later on. So you know, if you're getting an opportunity to take a more authority position, a higher up position, I think you should take that. It's not really just about the money; it's also about the responsibility and gaining, you know, taking a higher position. Anytime you take a higher position, it's going to be easier, I think, even to switch fields, because you can always say that you've been in this higher position. So I would do that, and plus you're going to get valuable experience being in a higher position. And then I would say, in that new position, even though it's sort of system administrator role, try to do as much software development work if possible. Now, you know, you might say, "Well, John, that doesn't make sense because it's not a software development role." But hey, everybody needs tools, and that's, you know, I've been in positions where I haven't been quoted a software developer, especially when I was starting out my career, but I found ways to write code by writing tools to do my job, tools to help other people do their job, and that's always a good way to be able to get that practice on the job and get paid for it. Now, it's a tough choice, I'd say, between paying the extra 20K or not to go for the master's. You know, it really depends here. I'd look at your current financial situation to determine this. So if you're making like 80K a year right now, 20K more is probably a big amount. And then if you're making 120K right now, go ahead and invest the 20K. So that's what's really going to determine this. You know, if you're on a budget, if you're making less money, learning online is probably going to be your best choice. If throwing 20K into something that that may be valuable or not, it's going to hurt you much more significantly, and probably it's not a good investment. But if you're making a lot of money, if you have that extra money, then I would say go ahead and go with the master's program. It's going to be even if it turns out to be not the best investment, even if you could have learned online, you might save yourself some time and trouble, right? You know, maybe it takes you 6 months to learn, or a year to learn something by yourself, but if you could do this program and pay 20K, maybe they're going to have it kind of charted out for you, and maybe that would be worth it, especially if you said it's being taught by industry professionals. So it sounds like it's more like a boot camp than it is like a traditional education. So I think, you know, as far as the master's itself, I think it's more likely to help you in the current, you know, path that you're on with the system administrator and taking a higher responsibility, but it's not necessarily going to help you so much as a software developer. The key thing is what you learn from it, and that's what's going to help you the most. So Anyway, I hope that that helps you. It's sort of a tough situation. I don't think you can really go super wrong here, but I would just be careful to, you know, I always tell people to try to take more responsibility rather than just looking at pay. And I think you have an opportunity to do both here. Take the higher job that's gonna give you more responsibility, that's gonna get you more pay, and learn software development as you're doing this to look to make a, you know, a sort of a horizontal transition so that you can come in as a senior software developer rather than, you know, saying, okay, well, this isn't the path I want to go, so I'm not going to accept this job and I'm going to go ahead and start as a low-level software developer. I think that's the choice I wouldn't do. Instead, I would, you know, keep going up, and then hopefully you can make a horizontal transition over time. And the question of whether or not you do the master's degree or learn on your own is really going to depend on how much money you're making now. Like I said, if you're making like 120K or something like that, then yeah, it's a no-brainer. Just pay the money and have someone, you know, help you to learn this much faster than you could on your own. But if money is a big thing, then I don't know. Then maybe you have to think a little bit more about this. Anyway, hopefully this advice is helpful to you. If you have a question for me, just email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Take care.